Today is the fourth day of the ninth month on our Maker's Restored calendar. This 9-4 waypoint falls on the day of the moon, 10-22, on his servant Satan's calendar. The Almighty did not send forth the Emmanuel man-child Mahershalal Kushbath last night on his fourth messenger of blood delivery waypoint. Instead, he has continued to shorten the days through keeping this man-child and his three siblings in his Isaiah chapter 8 prophetess's womb. If he had not continued to shorten the days by continuing to keep these four offspring of his Isaiah chapter 6 holy seed in the womb, he would have had to let loose his hot indignation upon you yesterday prior to his fourth messenger of blood delivery waypoint. I say this because his word tells us the following in Isaiah chapter 66 verses 6 and 7. The voice of a war from the city and the voice from the palace. Yehweh's voice that will make good on his reward to his enemies before she travails to bear and before his cord goes forth and the man-child is delivered. His enemies are all of you that live in rebellion to the word of his mouth. They are all of you that summon to his name falsely. They are all of you that are stealing from him by not bringing your tithes and your offerings into the depository of his house in order to sustain his second son of his anointing oil and the dual wives of his Zechariah chapter 5 prophecy. It is good news for the inhabitants of the world that Yehweh has continued to shorten the days of his wrath through afflicting his anointed in your stead. However, his holding back, letting loose his wrath, does not negate the fact that the 168 days of the great and the fearful day of his wrath did in fact begin today. Therefore, it does not negate the fact that we are running out of days for him to be able to continue to shorten the days. Plus, he sent forth a couple of major warnings yesterday on his fourth messenger blood delivery waypoint. In the last video, I spoke that he was going to cause the Yellowstone caldera to begin to blow forth yesterday and or send forth the Cascadia subduction zone tsunami. He obviously did neither. However, he did send forth an underreported 2.7 shaking at Yellowstone and three very big shakings off the northwest coast of this great Elohim-like city of America. I say an underreported 2.7 because the statistics from some of the other sensors that are in the area indicated that this shaking was much bigger than this. The USGS is most assuredly hiding what is going on at Yellowstone, especially yesterday with missing data and such. They obviously needed to do so in order to keep the calm. And the trio of shakings that he sent forth near the Cascadia subduction zone and off the coast of this Elohim forsaken land last night, a little bit before midnight, were very large. Here are some of the numbers for them. The first of them was a magnitude 6.6, 218 kilometers southwest of Port Hardy, Canada, at 22:39:40, according to the time zone at Yehweh's house, which is UTC minus 7. It was only 11 kilometers deep on this 11th day of his 11 days journey from Hurricane Michael. 6.6 parallels today's first day of Yehweh's hot indignation, being the 66th day from the 600th day of him causing his anointed to approach near to him three strokes per day. Today is the 666th day of him causing me to do so, paralleling his mark of the beast. His mark of the beast is upon the right hands and the foreheads of all of you that have not turned back to him through that which he's restored through his end time Elijah. Yehweh sent forth the flood in the 600th year of his servant Noah's life. He did so 66 years after he told him to start building the three tiers of the boat. There are 218 days that encompass yesterday's fourth messenger blood delivery waypoint and 318 of this year on his servant Satan's calendar. 318 parallels him descending upon his holy mountain Horeb in the thick dark cloud and the thunderings and the lightnings and speaking his 10 words to our ancestors on 318. It also parallels his servant Abraham's 318 refined sermons and John 3:18. John 3:18 tells us that believing into his only begotten Son is believing into the word of Elohim. The last major earthquake that he set forth at the Cascadia subduction zone was 318 years ago in the year 1700. The numbers in the times that he set forth these three strokes of shakings last night and the other details that he wove into them, such as their coordinates and such, are also significant. However, I want to keep this video relatively short, so I'm just discussing a couple of these details that he wove into them. The second of these three shakings was a magnitude 6.8, 197 kilometers southwest of Port Hardy, Canada, at 23:16:28. That was the depth of just 10 kilometers. There are 197 days that encompass his 217 waypoint that he set forth the flood in the 600th year of his servant Noah's life, and yesterday's fourth messenger blood delivery waypoint of four. Strong's number 197 is the Hebrew word for a porch. This word is used 34 times in the testimony of his word, paralleling the 34 chapters of his truths that he has caused to be written upon the three tiers of four of the 46 great whitewashed stones of the boulder design of his house, with his Ezekiel chapter 9 writer's ink horn that he has put upon his end time son of Adam's dual loins. He has caused there to be five porches at this place that shelter our five tents per the five porches that were by the pool of Bethesda that was by the sheep's gate. The first time that this Hebrew word for a porch is used is in relation to the 20 cubits by 10 cubits of the porch that his servant Solomon had built for the first house that he caused to be built under his name. This 20 cubit by 10 cubit measurement ties into this coming 9/11 waypoint in an awesome way. I will discuss how it does so in another video. This year's 217 anniversary of the day that he set forth the flood was on 4/8 on 4/8 on his calendar. Or actually, 4/8 on his servant Satan's calendar. 4/8 this year was the 21st anniversary of the day that he brought his Isaiah chapter 8 prophetess into the world. This 6.8 shaking parallels him finishing the 144-cubit tall wall around this place 68 days prior to last night's fourth messenger of blood delivery waypoint. The third stroke of these three shakings that he set forth last night on his fourth messenger of blood delivery waypoint was a magnitude 6.5, 223 kilometers southwest of Port Hardy, Canada, 6 minutes and 20 seconds later at 23:22:48. That was also the depth of 10.0 kilometers. These 223 kilometers parallel his Joel 2:23 prophecy that tells us that I am his teacher of righteousness, that he has sent to teach you his straight and narrow pathway in order to circumcise your hearts. This third shaking being a 6.5 is beyond amazing. I say this not only because yesterday was the 65th day from the 600th day, but also because this coming 9/11 waypoint, the Emmanuel man-child Mahershalal Kushbaz will have been in the womb for an additional 65 days. The significance of this is his Mahershalal Kushbaz prophecy tells us the following in Isaiah chapter 7, verses 8 and 9. Because the head of Syria is Damascus, and the head of Damascus is Rezin, and for, or on account of 65 years, the people from Ephraim will be filled with terror. The head of Ephraim is Samaria, and the head of Samaria is Remaliah's son. If you will not believe this, it is because you do not believe. The Almighty El is getting ready to cause you to believe him. His word tells us that he has sent me to you in the manner of a day for a year. Therefore, this is a prophecy that is for on account of a certain 65 days. It is on account of a final 65-day period of time of him allowing you to continue stealing from him by not sustaining his anointed and you're submitting to his name falsely that he is going to smite you with the judgment of his word. I thought that yesterday's 65th day from day number 600 was this 65th day. However, he has now shortened the days into another 65th day, and this coming 65th additional day of this Emmanuel man-child being in the womb is certainly a doozy. Come 9/11, Meher's twin sister Rachel will have been in the womb for an additional 118 days. You should take the time to read Psalms 118 in the context that this psalm is written upon his end-time son of Adam. Verses 10 through 12 are three strokes of Yehweh telling us that I am going to circumcise all of the heathens in Yehweh's name that will come and revolve around me. Look up the words for yourself. He has sent me forth to circumcise the foreskins of your hearts. This Hebrew word for circumcise is used 36 times in the testimony of his word. 36 days prior to today's first day of the great and the fearful day of his wrath was the last great day of the Most High Feast of Ingathering as a result of him extending this feast to 14 days. These 36 days parallel the 36 days of his account of the flood. He caused his servant Noah to remove the covering 36 days after he caused his servant Noah to let loose the third tier of the dove. This particular last great day of this feast was the day that Yeshua prophesied of in John 7, 37 and 38 when he stood up and cried out, "If any man thirst, let him come unto me and drink. According to the scripture that says, he that believes into me, rivers of living waters will flow out from his belly." Since the revelations of his son, chapter 19, verse 13, tell us that the name that he gave to his only begotten son is the word of Elohim, from a third-party perspective, we can substitute Yeshua's references to himself with the name that his father gave to him. Doing so is the key of David. Therefore, when Yeshua stood up and cried out these words on the last great day of this feast, he cried out, "If any man thirst, let him come unto the word of Elohim and drink. According to the scripture that says, he that believes into the word of Elohim, rivers of living waters will flow out from his belly." He that believes into the word of Elohim is he that is speaking to you. Recently, Yehweh has caused his servant to send forth the first three parts of the four parts of a video series that is called 9/11 was custom made for 9/11. Ever since his third messenger of blood delivery waypoint came and went, and up until last night when he again did not send forth the Emmanuel man-child Mahershalal Kushbaz, I have thought that this coming 9/11 waypoint was going to be the day that this man-child and the faithful witness twins, Zechariah and Uriah, were going to be circumcised. Meditate upon this and this coming 9/11 waypoint in relation to what Psalms 118 verses 10 through 12 tell us in regards to him sending me forth in his name to circumcise all of the heathens that will come and revolve around his anointed. Meditate upon this in relation to this man-child being in the womb for an additional 65 days on this 9/11 waypoint and in relation to the 65 days of his Mahershalal Kushbaz prophecy. This coming 9/11 waypoint will be the one smooth stone anniversary of the first time that the King of Kings and his King were reviled on account of the manner that he is sending forth this man-child. His Mahershalal Kushbaz prophecy tells us the following concerning this first reviling, given to us in the last two verses of Isaiah chapter 8 and the first verse of chapter 9. Harshness will pass over them, and it will be that they will be starving when they hunger, and they will be wroth, and they will revile their king and their Elohim, and they will turn their faces upwards, and they will look to the earth, and they will behold adversity and dark darkness and gloom and anguish, and they will be thrust into thick darkness. Because the first time that you are reviled, there will not be obscurity and anguish in the land of Zebulun and in the land of Naphtali. And afterwards you will be honored in the pathway of the sea on the other side of the Jordan at the folding door or at the Galilee for the heathens. Zebulun and Naphtali and the pathway of the sea of Galilee and the folding door for the heathens are prophecies that are for this place that he has chosen for his name to dwell here. His house is soon going to become some oceanfront property in Arizona. Believe him. On this coming 9/11 waypoint, the faithful witness twins, Zechariah and Uriah, will have been in the womb for an additional 39 days. These 39 days parallel things like the 39 additional years that Yehweh caused his servant Abraham to live for after Abraham was willing to offer up his only begotten son of his wife Sarah's womb to Yehweh. This coming 9/11 waypoint will fall on 10/29 on his servant Satan's calendar. 10/29 was the first day of him causing me to approach near to him 3 strokes per day on his restored calendar. The 10th day of the 7th month is the Most High's commanded observance of his Day of Atonement. Yehweh my Elohim caused his end-time Elijah to remove the covering from the boulder design of his house for this day and to leave it uncovered since then. Today's first day of the great and the fearful day of Yehweh is the 55th day of his altar remaining uncovered. The significance of 55 is he has used this number to mark his Isaiah chapter 55 signature ring that he's put upon my hand. He began to do so 55 days after the first waypoint that he sent me with back in 2011. He sent forth the 9.0 shaking off the coast of 1,000 generations Japan that caused the tsunami that is still killing off the oceans of the world. He caused his anointed to blow the shofar of a ram's horn at 7:34 a.m. on his Day of Atonement this year to begin my third petition of the day to him. The drawn-out shofar blast that ended this third petition to him on that day fulfilled his Leviticus chapter 25 verse 9 prophecy to set forth the 170 days that will take us to the year of the ram's horn release of debts. If you want for him to release your debts that you have to him on account of your stealing from him, I suggest that you come and revolve around his anointed. Today is the 187th day of the 360 days of his perfect one smooth stone. Therefore, tomorrow will be the 188th day. In light of his 188-day, 189-day earthquake cycle, could he send forth a bit of a larger warning shaking tomorrow on the 188th day? Or on the 189th day? Or both? Perhaps. Either way, 9/11 approaches quickly. And either way, we have now entered into the 168 days of the great and the fearful day of Yehweh. The testimony of his word says so. Believe him and turn back to him through that which he has restored. Or else prepare for your rebellious, uncircumcised hearts to die in your unbelief.